What's up, guys? Cheap Beast, aka Noah, back today bringing another video. This time we're doing the April sneaker releases. This month, honestly, there weren't a ton of sneakers, but some of the stuff is actually really good. There's a few decent collabs, and then there's a few like decent models, but there really is only like maybe 10 to like 12 sneakers this month that I decided to write down. There's obviously going to be more stuff added on. It always happens that way. But as of right now, the start of April, these are the only sneakers coming out. First one that's coming out is on the 2nd. It's the Jordan 1 1985 Georgetown. It's going to retail for $200. So the 85 version is actually based on the original 1985 version. So it's not like the Jordan 1 that you'd get right now. That's why it's a little more expensive also. And then it's in the Georgetown colorways. So it's going to be like navy and gray. They do Georgetown colorways a decent amount. I think it's pretty good looking sneaker. I don't know if I'd pay $200 for a Jordan 1. I've never had a pair of 1985s, the new ones or the old ones, obviously. So they might be a little more comfortable, a little different fit. For $200, might be a little more expensive, but obviously they're going to sell it because it's Jordan 1. Then on the 5th, we have the Jordan 1 Low in the Marina Blue. It's going to retail for $100. This is, so if you guys remember a few months ago, maybe the end of last year, there's the Dark Marina Blue. This is basically like the same color, but lighter. And it's a Jordan 1 Low. I obviously like lows, and I think they're really good to pick up for the summer, which is coming around soon. But I don't think it's a bad colorway. I mean, if you like this lighter blue colorway, it's not as dark as the Dark Marina Blue that was on the highs. I think it's a good colorway. I like really blue anything, so that's kind of why I put this on here. And it's a decent one. $100, definitely not a bad one pickup. Also on the 5th, we have the Polaroid Nike SB Dunk Low. It's going to retail for $120. This is actually a collab with Polaroid and Nike SB, obviously on the SB Dunk Low. It features the Polaroid Spectrum swoosh on it, so you can actually see there's like three different swooshes on there. There's a blue, yellow, and red, and that's mostly black on the upper part of the swoosh and then white all on the bottom. I think it's a pretty decent looking sneaker. I like the Polaroid like theme on it, that you, it's kind of subtle and like you wouldn't know it's a Polaroid colorway, but I do think it's pretty cool. I think it's one of the better sneakers, definitely probably one of the dunks. I've stopped writing like every dunk low that's been coming out of the month because they released a ton of them, but this one's actually a collab and it's an SB, so it's definitely a good one. Next up on the 8th, we have actually two sneakers. It's off-white Nike Blazer Low. It's gonna be two colorways, that's really what I mean. Retail for $140. There's the two colorways, so there's the black and green and then the white and red. I personally like the white and red a little more just because I feel like it'd be a little easier to wear. Not saying that this sneaker is gonna be really easy to wear to begin with. So it features a lot of like signature off-white stuff, so that there's that extra lacing like system on it. And then there's holes on the upper. And if you look at some of the other off-whites, I feel like there hasn't been a ton on the Nikes, but if you look at like actual off-white shoes, there's a lot of holes on stuff. I don't know if these have like a clear plastic to protect it, or it's just straight through, which would be kind of weird. And that's also got an extended sole. So on the white one, it's a little different colored. And I forget on the black one if it's a little bit different colored. It's crazy looking. I don't know if these obviously won't do like crazy. I think they're gonna sell out, and there will be a little bit of resell on them just because they're off-whites. These were actually designed by Virgil before his passing, so I think people will like them for that reason. I think the sneakers are right. I don't think it's anything too crazy, but I wouldn't expect these to resell for anything crazy. Then also on the 8th, we have another collab. This one's for the Union LA in the Jordan 2 in the Gray Fog. It's going to retail for $225. This is the latest collab between Union and Jordan. This time it's on a Jordan 2. I actually think this colorway is really good. It's basically like all like a light gray with some blue accents, and there's like some yellow accents too. It's a pretty simple colorway. I feel like Union sometimes does a lot of like, not crazier stuff, but more colorful stuff. But I think this one's pretty cool. I actually really like it. It seems like they're pushing out Jordan 2's a lot. I feel like I noticed that earlier. I think this is a really good collab. I would imagine it releases on Union's site and then maybe on sneakers later. I don't know exactly how this is going to release. I think it is pretty cool. I like the Jordan 2. I mean, I have never had a pair, but it looks pretty simple, and I like the colorway on this one. And then the next day on the 9th, we have one of the more common restocks for Yeezys. It's the Yeezy 350 V2 in the zebra colorway. It's going to retail for $230. So that seems to be about the new retail price for Yeezy 350 V2s. So $10 more than normal. It used to be $220. But it's just another restock of the zebras. And at this point, I don't know if the resale is like as crazy as it used to be, but it's probably still around like $400. I have a pair of zebras. I like them. But if you haven't picked one up, another good chance to pick something up. Then on the 12th, we have a pack of sneakers. I don't even know if they're a pack, but I'm gonna put them all together. They're a bunch of Air Maxes in animal prints. The first one is actually a golf sneaker. It's the Air Max 1 Golf in the tiger colorway. It's gonna retail for $140. The next one is the Air Max 90 in a leopard colorway. It's going to release for $150. And then the last one is another golf sneaker. It's an Air Max 97 in the zebra colorway. It's going to retail for $190. So there's two golf sneakers and one regular sneaker. There are a bunch of animal prints on it. I'm not a big fan of the animal print. If you're going to get one, I would say the zebra is probably the best looking one. It's a golf one, so if you're looking for something to wear while you're golfing, I feel like the animal print, the animal like fake hair, isn't the best either to be wearing for golfing. But if you're into animal print, they're men's sizing, so there's a bunch of them coming out. I imagine they're going to release on maybe just the Nike app. They might be on sneakers, but if you're looking for something for golf or with animal print, I'm surprised it's a men's sizing, not women's sizing, because they seem to do that. But on the 12th, there's a bunch of them coming out. Next up on the 16th, we have two sneakers. The first one is the Yeezy Foam Runner in sulfur colorway. That's going to retail for $90, so standard price for the Foam Runners. It's another Yeezy in the sulfur colorway. I feel like they've released a ton of them. They've definitely put them on the slides. I feel like there's been a 350 or at least some other ones. I don't remember exactly, but I feel like the sulfur colorway is pretty used for Yeezys. It's just a neutral, like more yellowish tint than some of the other ones. So if you're looking for some Foam Runners, hopefully you pick these ones up. I mean, anytime you can get them for retail, it's a lot better than paying like $200, $300 that they go for. But another just neutral colorway from Yeezy. Then also on the 16th, we have the Jordan 7 in the sapphire colorway. It's going to retail for $210. It's actually 2022 is actually the 30th anniversary of the Jordan 7. This one actually looks very similar to an ACG colorway. I forget what the exact colorway is. I feel like it's Moab Brown or something like that, but I'm not sure. But it's mostly tan with some sapphire accents. I actually think the colorway is pretty cool. I don't know if I'd be wearing a Jordan 7. If it was on a different sneaker, maybe I'd pick it up. It's probably going to sell out because every Jordan does. But I think it's pretty cool. I like the all tan and I like the sapphire accents. But Jordan 7, I don't know if I'm the biggest fan of it. It might be harder to wear for me. And then there's a huge gap. So the next sneaker is actually on the 29th. And there's really not a ton coming out in between the 16th and the 29th. Obviously, I feel like they're adding more, but nothing too major so far. But on the 29th, we have the Amon Meunier Jordan 2. Again, I feel like they're pushing Jordan 2s this year. And there's another collab on them. There's a Union and an Amon Meunier collab. It's going to retail for, I assume, $225 like the Union did. It's actually the third collab, but it's going out of order for Amon Meunier and Jordan. The first one was on, I think, the 3 and then the 1, and now it's on the 2. Very similar colorway. It's got like the brownish and like dark brown. I think it's pretty clean. I think I like the Union a little bit better than this one. But if you're into Jordan 2s, I think it's definitely cool one to pick up. I like the Amon Meunier colorways that they've been doing recently with Jordan. So hopefully they do some more simple colorways on some other Jordan models. And then the last confirmed sneaker is on the 30th. It's the Jordan 13 Brave Blue. It's going to retail for $200. I feel like I cover 13s all the time, but I've never tried to pick any up. But this one's going to release in full family sizing. It's in the Brave Blue, black and white. It's very similar to what it looks like a Flint colorway, but instead of the mostly white that the Flint has and that blue on it, it's going to have mostly black. So it's just kind of like the same thing as the Flint, but black. So if you're into the Flint and you like the black more than the white, this would be a cool one to pick up. Obviously, I don't think I'll be going for this one, but it was a decent one to point out. And then the last one, which isn't determined yet, but might be the biggest release of the month just because of it hasn't released in 7 years. That's the Yeezy 350 in the Turtle Dove colorway. So it's going to retail for maybe $200. That's what it originally released for back in 2015. I would imagine it's going to be a little more expensive, but it's actually the first restock, I think, of any of the original Yeezys since then. So I think it potentially, if it does release this month, it could be probably the biggest release of the month just because they haven't released in so long. Sure, there's a ton of like knockoffs and stuff that looks very similar to it. But if you're looking for one of the original 350s, this one's the first one coming out in 7 years. So I think it would be cool to pick up. I may try to go for it just because I've never actually had any of the original 350s. Like I said, one of the original four colorways. I feel like it was probably one of the more popular ones. At one point, they were selling for over $1,000. I don't know what the resale on is now. I imagine it's still pretty expensive because anyone who has a dead stock Turtle Dove, it's a 7-year-old sneaker at this point. So if it does release, probably the biggest one of the month. It's not one of the collabs or anything, not a Union Muneer, Amon Muneer, Off-White. But since it hasn't released in such a long time, I would imagine a lot of people are trying to go for them. So that's everything for April. Like I said, nothing, like there's not a ton of sneakers, but I think there's a good amount of like quality sneakers. Obviously, there's a huge gap between like the 16th and the 29th, so there's not a ton of sneakers coming out. I imagine they will add more, but we do have an Off-White, we have a Union, we have a Yeezy restock potentially, and an Amon Muneer all in the same month. So it could be a very good month if they add a lot of other stuff to it. So hopefully there's some good stuff coming out throughout the rest of the month. But let me know in the comments what you're most excited for, and also which one you're definitely trying to pick up. So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and yeah, I'll see you guys later.